We are going to move right into Tim, the
Motivator
Williams, man. I'm telling you what, you better bring it, man, because you can't roll around with a name like that.
That's the only way I know how to
that's
roll.
It. That's so, we met at a seminar we did here in the building, and then we were talking about some branding and adding value and all that stuff. And man, just what you do just looks to me sounds like fun. First of all,
it's definitely
fun. You've been on a journey, haven't you?
On a mission,
yeah,
a serious mission.
Well, let's tell everybody.
Yeah, it's Timothy the Motivator Williams, author of the book How to Sell Yourself and Become Rich, available on my website, themotor-vader.com, MOTOR, business sales strategist, expert sales trainer, motivational speaker.
I think you've done this before.
Well, a few times. Well, my background is automotive sales.
Yeah.
And that's where the motor part comes from. Pretty much branding my company. And my goal is to help businesses, entrepreneurs, grow.
Yeah.
You know, everything in sales is what I teach people, and that's what the book is about, how to sell yourself. And basically, you know, you need to know two things: what is selling and how to sell yourself.
Right.
Because whatever product you're selling, people are buying you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're selling something tangible, intangible, whether it's a car or there's insurance.
That's it.
You know, if I come to you and you're rude, you just propel me. You didn't sell me on you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I want to know that you have integrity, principles, morals, values, beliefs.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? You're sincere. You're genuine. You know, nobody wants to feel like they've been taken advantage of.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people do that. You know what I'm saying? And so my goal is to show people how to actually grow your business, because right now, I mean, it's wide open. You know, with the internet, you can put yourself online, on YouTube, on Facebook, and have business going in your kitchen, in your bedroom. You know what I'm saying? But most people don't know how. Okay, how do I do that? What are the steps? You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people. The reason I started doing this was because a lot of people were really struggling. You know what I'm saying? They either own a job that they're not happy. You know what I'm saying? It's just, I'm here to get a paycheck. You know what I'm saying?
There is an entrepreneur awakening that happens within somebody at some point and once you get there, and you're right, you step back and you see some of this other stuff going on.
Right.
And you're right. Sometimes you just get lost in all that.
Lost.
And it takes that outside view to say, you know, hey, there's a different way to skin this cat.
Exactly. And especially, you know, also, I mean, what I try to do is, if you're on a job and you like it, okay, let me show you how to really grow in it.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? Or, okay, my goal is to do this. Work from 9 to 5 if you want to get off. If you're an entrepreneur, you want to get off of that job. Then from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m., you get wealthy.
Yeah.
But there are so many people, they talk about, I'm unhappy, but they don't really do anything about it. They don't take any action.
Yeah.
And what I do is, okay, I'm going to educate you. Then I'm going to motivate you, then inspire you to do it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I found out probably six, seven months ago, I have a friend that told me, he said, hey, I went on Facebook and seen you doing speaking. I said, yeah. He said, man, you know, you were motivating us in high school. I said, what?
You've been doing this your whole life. You didn't even know.
I didn't even know it. It was just me, just the way I am. But then I just walked into that space.
Yeah.
You know, I have a workshop called How to Align Your Personality with Your Passion and Prosper. Basically, what you need to find out is, some people tell you, okay, you know, you got to love what you do. Well, the problem with that is, you're not going to love what you do until you get good at it.
Right.
When I got in car sales, I didn't like it.
Yeah.
Until I got good at it.
Yeah.
But I wanted to get good at it.
Right.
So I bought books. I was the type of person that I was passionately curious.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I would bug people. I put it in my book. I would literally come to you every day and annoy you.
You know, that's what Napoleon Hill did in Think and Grow Rich, man. He just showed up on his door and was look, I'm here and I'm not leaving until you give me a job.
Exactly.
And he worked for however many years, not getting paid, but it was just, he just
20
wanted
years.
To learn.
Yeah, he worked 20 years.
Yeah.
And he said that in his book. He said, how many people would do that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I did that. You know, I've been in sales 23 years. So basically what I want to do is go into different companies, because I write a lot of workshops, and there's not one company that I can't go into and help, because everything is selling.
Sure.
But if you go to a company, let's say you go to Wendy's and you ask the cashier, whatever, they're a salesperson, they'll say no. But this is what happens. If you go to the drive thru and you say, I want a chicken sandwich, what'd they say?
Though you get upsell something.
Exactly.
Fries, apple pie, something.
But the only thing they're doing is reading the script.
Sure.
But they don't know that they are selling.
Yeah.
And most people say, I'm not a salesperson. Everybody is.
Yeah.
You know, if you're a home mother and you stay at home, you're selling your kids on eating the vegetables.
I was just about to say, so and this just happened yesterday. having to sell the kids on how important it is to clean up after yourself
exactly.
and cohabitate. Now, exactly. if that's not the hardest selling job out there, man, hard. I don't know what is.
It is. It is. And this is the interesting thing. The kids are the best salespeople.
Yeah.
They're relentless. When they want something.
Oh, that's it.
Oh, man.
They're batting the eyes. Exactly. You're getting the heartbreak. Oh, yeah.
Everything. And they're off tears. Temper tantrum. I mean, they'll do everything. And we have actually, we were like that.
Yeah.
You know, but what happened is schools, unfortunately, suppresses that.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? It suppresses your imagination. You know what I'm saying? Mm. And that's what I want to bring back. And that's when you do that, I've talked to so many people just over the phone I've never met. They'll find me on Facebook or LinkedIn or YouTube or somewhere like that and give me a call and, you know, ask me, what do you do, basically? And when I tell them, it's like, I need you.
Yeah.
Our company here needs you. I get calls like that every day. But my goal was to write the book to where it's not just in a box.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I wrote it to where whatever business it is, I can go in there and help them. And really my epiphany came from when I was in Atlanta. I was doing things, just being creative, doing things out of the box, prospecting, follow up, just doing it different. And after 2 years, the company implemented what I was doing. We had a big meeting.
Yeah.
And this is the interesting part. The majority of the salespeople came to me and they were like, man, you got us doing this. And it was like, it was more work. That's what they were looking at. They're like, I'm like, dude, if you do this, it will make you money.
Yeah, you're going to get paid. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, sure.
You know, then when I came back down here in 2007 and worked for a company, and my, the owner brought me into the office. He said, Tim, how much money do you need to make? I said, $10,000 a month. He said, well, you got to get to work. I said, I know. You didn't let me go and get out of your office. And what's crazy is, and I have it right here.
Yeah.
The next month, I made $10,800. And he came to me. He's like, Tim, you did it. I said, yeah. I said, that was the goal.
I sort of followed my own plan.
Exactly. And that's the goal. And so what I want to do is show people that when you have a goal, you need to break them down. You need to understand it. You know, it's three steps to a goal. You have fantasy, theory, and fact. But the problem is most companies will say, hey, what's your goal this month? If you're a parts manager, whatever, what's your goal? How many houses are you going to sell this year?
Right.
But they don't never train you on how to sell the house. They train you on real estate.
Yeah.
But that's it. You just train you on the product, but they don't train you on the person you're going to talk to and yourself. So when I come in and do training, I train you on you. I show you that you have unlimited potential. You know what I'm saying? Because you do.
I mean, you're preaching to the choir over here, man.
So I know.
You, as any good salesperson, business person, business owner, the moment that you realize you can no longer, and we said this in the seminar, you can no longer sell any product.
Right.
Because it's not about that.
Exactly.
You are the product.
You're it.
And the second that you start investing some time into that,
that's it.
It's like you said, you can just kind of apply this to whatever, whether it's gas, whether it's ice, it's Eskimos we're selling it, whatever.
Exactly.
It's just, it's a matter of some self-development and really building into a system.
That's it. That's all. And that's what I created. I have a system.
I should have written your book, man.
Man, hey. Do the next one. You can co-author the next one.
That's it. So so let's talk about your company and why it's different and why you're becoming so successful with it.
Right, right. Basically, I started studying a lot of trainers, you know, like I said, about maybe 20 years ago. And what happens is a lot of them, even motivational speakers, they say they're going to help you come to the seminar or whatever, but when they speak, it's kind of like just spray and pray. You know what I'm saying? They kind of just vomit on the audience. I got this prepared speech and they give it to you and hopefully you get something out of it. And the way I looked at that was, let's say you come to a doctor's office. There's 15 people in there. And I come out as the doctor and I give the same prescription to all the 15 people.
Right.
Is it going to help everybody?
Sure.
It's not. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, I
need to find out, okay, you have for a headache, you got chest pains, you have leg problems. I need to find out what it is. So all my presentations are tailored. So when I go in somewhere, I pretty much find out, okay, what are you having problems with?
You're right.
You know what I'm saying? Just like a doctor. And pretty much what I do is I take the pulse of the audience. Just like when you go to the doctor, the first thing they do is what? Take your pulse, put the thermometer in your mouth, take the stethoscope, put it in your chest, breathe in and out, take the blood pressure. It's the same thing every time. You know what I'm saying? And so that's basically what I do. I take the pulse of the audience, take their blood pressure, find out their temperature.
Yeah.
And then what I do is I tailor my presentations right then for them to help them. So I engage them. I ask questions. When I do sales training at car dealerships, I do the same thing. What problems are you having? Is it follow-up, prospecting, gaining more business? What is it? And I'll show you how to do that. But it's pretty much like you have to understand this. When you understand that selling is everything, you understand, okay, what is selling? You know, the theory of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You need to understand that. Now, how to sell yourself. Now, if you don't know you, how are you going to sell yourself to somebody else?
Sure.
And so that's what I do. I actually show you about you. You know, I get into, you know, how does the mind work? How does the subconscious mind work? How do you actually think about something, send that signal out into the universe, because thoughts penetrate to all time and space, and that comes back.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Now, once I got you there, now we can build. We got to set a foundation and build off of that. Once I show you, you have unlimited potential. Now, once I teach you that, because that's a whole workshop in itself.
Sure.
And then I show you, okay, now you got to take action. I don't know what you want to do, but you want to sell cars, you want to sell furniture, sell real estate. You need to take massive action. Now, once you take massive action, what's going to happen is you're going to get unbelievable results. Now, that unbelievable results is going to create a phenomenal belief system. That's what happened with me. When I started selling, I couldn't. I didn't know.
Validation is a very powerful tool.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so once I started reading all these books, bugging these guys, hey, how do I be successful? What's the keys to success? I would ask questions like this every day. I never talked about the football game. I want to know how to be successful. Then I would leave work, go to the bookstore. You know, on Sunday, sit at home and just read books and read books. And so I gathered all this information, but the goal was to be able to help people, not just have a bunch of knowledge.
Sure.
And I could just sit home with or just tell everybody about. Yeah. My goal was, if you're struggling, I can help you. If you're struggling at the bank, if you're struggling at a financial company, real estate, it doesn't matter where. Let me show you how to market yourself offline and online. I know a lot of people that have businesses, they don't have a Facebook fan page.
Yeah. See what I tell you, Joe. You got to have Facebook.
You got to have it. They have a business. No videos on YouTube. You're not marketing yourself right. You know what I'm saying? To give you an example of how I helped a lady, someone I went to high school with, she told me, we was on the phone. She said, well, I'm about to hang up because I'm going to go tutor at the library. I said, okay, you started a tutoring business. She said, no. I said, okay, why are you tutoring for someone else? Because she has a master's in special education.
Mm-hmm.
She lives in Mobile, Alabama, but she teaches in Mississippi. I said, okay. I said, when you finish that tutoring, give me a call. So she called me. She said, what's up? I said, come to my office. So she came. I said, we need to start you a business. I said, you have a master's in special education. Why are you working for someone else? So I said, we need to create a flyer.
Right.
I said, okay, you want to do it or you want my team to do it? So she went ahead and went home and created the flyer. I said, okay. I said, text me a picture of it when you finish it. She texted me a picture of it. I said, now take that flyer, email it to you, because she had it on the phone. Mm-hmm. I said, email it to your flash. Download to your flash. Mm-hmm. Take that to FedEx Kinko's. Print it off. Print about 10 of them off. I said, when you do that, call me. She got there, did it, called me. I said, take these flyers to the old apartment complex you used to live at. She took it over there. She said, what do I do? I said, don't worry about that. Just go to the leasing office.
Just go over there and hang them up.
Take it.
Yeah.
So I said, go to the leasing office and ask them, get permission, if it would be okay to pass these out.
Sure.
She walked in there, because she hung the phone. She walked in there and did it. She called me back. She said, Tim, you're not going to believe this. I said, what? She said, I went in the leasing office and asked the lady at the leasing office if I could pass them out. She said, don't worry about that. We'll make copies of them and give them to the maintenance guys.
Nice.
And have them pass them out.
Nice.
She couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
I'm knowing all of this in my head. What's going on? What's going to happen? This is why I strategically told her what to do. So she left there. Called me back again. She said, Tim, I just left there, but you're not going to believe this. I said, what? She said, a lady called me and asked me, how much do I charge for tutoring?
She's like, Tim, how much do I charge?
Exactly. That's what it was.
Yeah.
And so I told her, I said, come to my office again. We need to start your business.
Yeah.
We need to create your website, create your Facebook fan page, create some videos on YouTube of you tutoring, because with that, you can leverage into Skype. And what we can do is we can have you tutoring, since her sister lives in Atlanta, we can have you tutoring kids in Atlanta on Skype.
Yeah.
I said, it's unlimited. I said, now we need to write some children's books. I said, we need to scale your business. And that's what I do.
Yeah. Do you find technology is helping you tremendously?
Tremendously.
Yeah.
Tremendously. I get calls all day because I have, you know, almost 100 videos on YouTube. And then that links to my website. And then that links to my Facebook.
Yeah.
So they get to see all my information without me having to do anything.
Yeah.
It's 24 hours running. It's automated.
Yep.
So they can go to my website, boom, download my book, buy it, read it. And then now they can learn more about me. Now they're going to call me.
Yeah.
You know, I did a call, I was telling you earlier before we started, with Team Wealth Infinity out of Georgia. Did maybe about an hour conference call.
Mm-hmm.
The lady inboxed me on Facebook a year ago. Said, hey, I'm setting up this speaking conference. I want you to be a part of it. I said, okay. I didn't even remember it when she called me back.
Yeah.
She said, it's set up. I want you to be on there for November the 3rd. I said, okay. I did that conference with them. She said, Tim, you have probably been the best speaker we've had. Because these were just a lot of entrepreneurs. The next day, a lady that was on that call called me and said, where do I get your book? Bought my book. She said, I have a life insurance business in Dawson, Georgia. I want you to come here and train me and help me build it.
Sometimes, man, that's all it takes, a good 30,000 foot view.
That's it.
When's your next speaking engagement?
The next one is going to be in Atlanta. I got to find out the date. I'm having small ones coming up. I don't know where, because they're setting up the dates in Birmingham and Montgomery, but I have the big one in April. They haven't emailed me the date yet.
Very cool. All right, man. Well, let's send everybody to all your good sites and stuff and you said it earlier, one of my favorite terms I've learned as an entrepreneur is called residual income.
Exactly.
The money you get to make while you are asleep.
That's it.
All right, man. Well, let's tell them where they can find all your stuff and get in touch with you.
Google me, Timothy the Motivated Williams. Everything will pop up. TheMotor-Vader.com, MOTOR. Find me on Facebook, facebook.com/TheMotivator. LinkedIn, Super Salesman 1. Instagram, The Motivator. Twitter, The Motivator. I'm all over. If you Google me, I'll come up. I'm everywhere, always.
That's it.
Don't sleep. I'm allergic to sleep.
And we got Bam. I'm going to give a shout out to Bam, who's over here filming Tim today. So hopefully we'll be sharing some YouTube links on our site later today to get some of this cool stuff.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
Man, I know we could probably go on for hours, but anything really truly important that we missed?
Everything, man. I love helping people. I really do. I'm going to be honest with you. I found my passion. I can't tell you how many CEOs, executives I've sat down with and say, Tim, I don't know my passion. You know, I spoke at Bishop State College.
I understand that. Man. I really do. And this comes from a chef, previous chef. So passion's been number one.
Right.
And one of the things that you kind of watched it fall away, or it got lost in somebody else's bottom line or vision, when you realize that it's either not there anymore or you're not really sure what it is, that's a huge moment to just say, okay, let's figure this out.
Let's figure it out.
Yeah.
And most people can't, you know, it amazes me. I'm like, you don't know your passion. So I have to help them find their passion and help them with that.
Sure.
You know, there are a lot of people just on jobs and they're just there. You know, they like, I have a bunch of CEOs said, this is not it. This is not it. But there are a lot of people that are plumbers that should be really painting all day. There are a lot of people that are electricians that should be singing all day.
Yeah.
You know, that's their passion, but they don't know how to monetize it. And that's what I do.
Yeah.
You know, and with
that's
businesses.
That's the eternal question, isn't it?
And then with businesses, there are a lot of businesses. They have, you know, employees, and they're like, they're not motivated. They're not inspired. They just show up for a paycheck.
Yeah.
You know, what I do is I show them, you know, you coming to work, is really work is not supposed to be for money. A lot of people don't know that. You know what I'm saying?
No, it's fun first.
Exactly. You're supposed to go to work for the experience. You know what I'm saying? You earn money, you know what I'm saying, and accumulate it and invest it. You know what I'm saying? But people are going to work for just a paycheck, and that's it. What I do is I come in and show you how to set that job. And the goal is not a paycheck. It's your dreams.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? Because the goal is just a dream with a deadline.
Sure.
And now I got you educated and motivated.
If the whole world was doing what they wanted to do as opposed to what they had to do when it came to making a living or work.
Exactly.
Yeah.
An interesting thing is they can.
Pretty powerful place.
Yeah, they can.
Yeah, just call Tim.
It's just fear. You know what I'm saying?
I hear you.
That's it.
I get it, man.
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank both of you for coming in today and hanging out with us. And, you know, we'll have all your stuff and links and everything on our side as well. And I'm curious to see how good Bam's editing skills are.
Me too.
You too? Yeah. You're on trial today, man. This is your go-to right here. So, okay, you guys, you can find us at P Cola Radio X on Twitter. You can find us on Facebook at P Cola BRX, or you can find us on our website at Pensacola.BusinessRadioX.com. Again, I want to thank Joan and Tim for coming in today.
Thank you.
I greatly appreciate it.
I appreciate it.
And this has been Pensacola Business Radio, where business is good and your work matters.